What is the point of life? Now, I'm sure everyone's going to have a different answer or a thought process leading to their answer, so I don't want to go too far into the mental, psychological reasons that we're alive or the religious possibilities of an afterlife or whatever you guys have in your own story that is going to make your life worth living. A lot of people live their lives chasing a dream, a purpose that they think is going to fulfill everything they need before their life ends. Nothing is permanent. Especially human life. Sorry if this is the first time you're hearing that, but personally, I think that's what makes it so much more beautiful and meaningful to be alive. Now, while these dreams we chase and the purposes we give ourselves are amazing motivators, important thing to remember is that these aren't the end-all be-all of life. If things don't go your way, which they usually don't, it doesn't mean you're a failure because you haven't achieved your purpose or your dream you've been chasing. And I know we all hate the cliche saying in the movies, it's the journey, not the destination, but in this case, I do think that's pretty accurate. So when you struggle with the question, what am I doing here? What's my purpose? What is life supposed to be? I don't have the answer for you. And most people probably don't. And if they tell you they do, they're probably lying or they're trying to get you into their MLM group on Facebook. And even though we may not have the answers, there are some movies I love to watch that make the answer seem a little closer.
Ground control to Major Tom.
The overarching theme we see in these films is that life itself is the point. It's not about perfecting things you think are important or impressive. It's just about being in the moment. And yeah, that's easier said than done. It's pretty hard to self-actualize when you're 2 weeks behind on rent and your car doesn't run and everything you see on social media is someone doing better than you. For example, let's take the secret life of Walter Mitty. In his mind, he's a dreamer who never achieved anything noteworthy or notable. So when given the opportunity to go on an adventure and mimic the life of someone who he sees as amazing, who knows what they're doing, who is eons above where he is in his position, he learns at the end that it's not about the moments you have along the way. Because yeah, these moments might be impressive to strangers on your dating profile when you say you've swam with great red sharks or you hiked a mountain in the Himalayas. But even after all these accomplishments that he did on his own, it's not until he meets with this famed adventurer photographer where he learns that it's not about capturing every moment, it's just about being in it.
When are you gonna take it?
Sometimes I don't. If I like a moment, I mean me, personally, I don't like to have the distraction of the camera. I just wanna stay in it.
And that theme is even pushed further when in the end, we see that the image that the photographer took that represents all of life, and you think someone who had so much experience and adventure, who lived life out in the world, would know what it all means. But when the image is revealed, it's not some fireworks show or some rare animal or some crazy picture taken hanging out of a helicopter. No, it's simple. Just Walter Mitty living life. The life that even when that picture was taken, he thought was unimportant and unimpressive. Now, many may say the meaning to life and the purpose is to subscribe down below to the channel. Now, on the opposite side of the spectrum, we have people who work their whole lives to achieve their purpose or their dream, but wake up the next day and realize that life still goes on. So why does this feeling occur if we think we found our purpose? What's next? Now, this doesn't only apply to people who ever reached this arbitrary, idea of success or whatever dream you're trying to accomplish. But it's also for those who feel like their life needs to amount to something further than the extent that their reach has on others. In Soul, we finally see Joe Gardner, whose purpose is playing piano and music and jazz, finally achieve his dream of becoming a professional musician. And just in that moment, he dies. Well, kind of. He pushes his way out of the line for the pearly gates and falls into the beginning, which is pretty much where souls are born and they find their spark for life or their purpose. Joe is mistakenly given the responsibility of taking care of 22, who is the 22nd soul ever created, who never found their spark to go to Earth, because for a soul to become a newborn life on Earth and become alive, they need to find their purpose and what it means to be alive for them. But of course, Joe's only worried about one thing, and that's getting back to achieve the dream that he set out for his whole life. His spark and purpose is happening down on Earth and he's not there. But when he finally gets back and is accidentally put into a cat and 22 is put into his body, he's able to watch his life from a third person perspective, which would be amazing if any of us could do. And for the first time, he wasn't just focused on himself or his dreams or his aspirations or what's next for him. He was finally able to notice the little things, people around him, the interactions he had on a daily basis, the feeling of being scared or nervous or standing up for yourself, or the wind on your face, or nature and the people around you. Just allowing those simple moments to mean something. And this idea is really expanded upon when Joe finally gets back to his body and is able to go perform the show that he's worked his whole life to be a part of. And at the end, he walks out and asks, what's next? But this is what he's told.
I heard this story about a fish. He swims up to this older fish and says, I'm trying to find this thing they call the ocean. The ocean, says the older fish, that's what you're in right now. This, says the young fish, this is water. What I want is the ocean.
After achieving this goal that he worked his entire life for, that he saw as his purpose, he felt the same, which I think is a feeling we can all relate to, where you finally do everything you're supposed to do. You go to school, you graduate college, you get a job that's okay paying, and you know, it's not that bad, you have a good schedule, you find someone you love and you settle down, you have a nice apartment or a house, you get a cute little dog who's like white and crusty, which, not me, no white and crusty dogs here. But even after all these accomplishments, you might still feel that you're stuck in the same spot and there's a giant ocean out there for you to explore. Things may always feel out of control and beyond you, and it's not until Joe was able to focus his music, not on this goal he had to become a professional musician and play in his great jazz band, but instead play for himself, focusing not on hitting the right notes or getting everything perfect, rather the little moments of his life, like standing on the beach with someone you love, or spending time with loved ones, or connecting with a stranger. And in that moment, he realizes the meaning of his life is just to be alive. I know this video is already getting pretty long, so the next one I'll just go through quickly. But going back to the 90s, we see in Groundhog Day, Bill Murray's character is stuck in this constant state of moving on to the next thing and worrying about the future. And it's not until he had to spend 10 to 40 years in the same day loop that he realized it's not about being able to achieve everything or perfect the perfect day and make everyone really impressed and save everyone you can, because there's moments where no matter what you do, there's always going to be the same outcome. And the only thing that allowed him to be released from this never-ending day was realizing that there's no special course of events needed to move on. It's only about enjoying each moment for what it is and not worrying about the future or what's next and living in that moment. But I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. I know I got a little sappy, and it's different than the usual meme-fied videos I put out. So if you do enjoy it, make sure you guys leave comments for any movies that you think are about life or give a great answer to the purpose of life. Because look, no one's going to know. You can put in the comments what you think the purpose is. I might go watch these three movies to help me feel a little better and not have that thought process, so I can just focus on living every day like it is. But make sure you guys subscribe and join our little community we have going on. And as always, thanks for watching.